started doing it. It's that woman again, and we've got a woman joining us as well. So we had to start early because I gotta be off today. Well, just after 1:45, actually. So you know, it's 9:49, and Evan turns around and says, Carl, you've got 58 minutes left. So, guys, do you want to do something really topical?
Yes, okie dokie.
We're going to get straight into it, right? No messing around, right? And it's you know, it's record. Well, the thing is, right? You know, we're not gonna go live on YouTube because we're not. That's it. End of story. Because me and Stav had a weirdo last week, didn't we, Stav?
Oh my God, yeah, it was weird.
Yeah, it was called Rosamond. She was a bit of a witch. anyway, so right, guys. Do you know where we're gonna go today?
No. We're going to Africa.
Oh my, do you know what? You nearly had it straight on, right? We're going to go, if you start AF and continue, you've got
Afghanistan.
You're so good, Stav. You know, you're just so, because you actually knew that this image of El Qanoum, which is in the northeastern part of Afghanistan, right? You knew full well that this was an archaeological site. Well done, Stav. You know, you are so... so more intelligent than that other bloke called Dave.
Yes, that's, I'm just above his IQ, you know.
Yeah, I know. Well, his IQ is only 25, so you haven't really done much to get above it.
24.
Well, no, that's true, you know.
20, the thing is, right, Dan, what, do you know the point I'd like to make, right?
Yeah, go on.
Evan has time travelled all the way down to Cardigan Castle, medieval Cardigan Castle, built by those damnable, horrible Normans, right, who've ruined our lives, right? He's in a prison cell in a proper bed, getting fed, right? And he's got the internet in the year 1286. I think that's amazing.
The thing is, the only thing he's going to have is toilet, so I have to do this thing on my bed.
You've got to do this thing on your bed? Oh, my God.
Yeah, I have to, like, poo and pee in my bed.
On your bed?
Yeah.
Well, actually, on the bed that you lie in. Right. Me and Stav have just voted we never, ever want to meet you. So the one thing I want to say about Afghanistan is really, really controversial, right? And is the history and archaeology in Afghanistan safe from the new government of the Taliban? Now, this is what we need to discuss, right? And we also need to look at if we take artifacts from foreign countries and put them in our museums, should we give them back? Now, hang on a minute, because Evan is actually in 1282, he would know nothing about this, right? So the only thing I'm actually asking now is Stave, right? Stave, so for example, say you took something from Iraq as an archaeologist in 1922 and Leonard Woolley's excavations at Ur, right? You took some artifacts and you put them in the British Museum, right? Should we have given them back to Iraq? That's the question.
No.
Why not?
Because we found them, so yeah.
Hang on a minute. No, and I've got a turkey making noise in the background because he's hungry, right? Hang on a minute, right? The point is that these artifacts come from Iraq, so what right have we got to keep them?
Because they didn't find them. Finders keepers.
Losers keepers.
Oh, shut up, you bunch of tarts. The thing is, right, it's the history and archaeology of places like Iraq, but I would argue... if we'd have given the artifacts back to Iraq and they ended up in a Baghdad museum, which was looted by American soldiers in 2003, those artifacts would have disappeared. So should we have given them back to them in the first place? That is the big question. Now, you're presuming that's what I'm going to say, right? So one of the things is that Afghanistan is one of the crossroads of civilization. It's got so much history and archaeology there, right? Do you know what? Alexander the Great, you know that great geezer on his horse, right? Alexander the great conqueror of the world, right? Obviously, Evan's never ever heard of Alexander the Great, so we've got to explain who Alexander the Great was. Alexander the Great was the son of Philip II of Macedon, right? And it was this tiny country in North Greece, right? And they decided that they were gonna conquer the Persian Empire, and they just couldn't stop. They kept going.
Yeah, I know all about him and our battle plans because we're going to invade him soon.
All right, that's okay then. That's fair enough. I'm glad you learned about him. Anyway, so this we're talking about Alexander the Great, right? Really conquering all of the old Persia, Iraq, Iran. He goes all the way to Afghanistan. He goes all the way into India and the Indus Valley, right? He's this great conqueror, right? And within 10 years of him conquering all this, Alexander the Dead, by the year 323 BC, we know it well, me and Stav know it well anyway, because we've been down there in a time machine and we sort of met Alexander the Great personally, and we actually drank wine with him. We got so drunk, we actually put poison in his drink and it killed him. But that's not my fault. I blamed on Stav. But the point is the whole thing is, well, Alexander the Great conquered a big chunk of Afghanistan. And if any of you guys seen the film, right, it's one of the greatest films ever. The Man Who Would Be King, by the very great Sean Connery and the very great Michael Caine. You ever seen that film?
I've seen it being advertised, but no.
What do you mean no? You can't say no. The question is, do we ask Evan if he's actually seen that film? Basically, it's about two British soldiers who actually decide to be kings of Afghanistan. And they rule for a little while, right? But unfortunately, there's this woman called Roxanne of Kuwak or something like that. Roxanne of somewhere. Roxanne of Afghanistan, right? And basically, Sean Connery decides to make right this woman his wife. But they all think Sean Connery's a god, yeah? So they give Sean Connery all his gold. Unfortunately, he marries this woman and she bites him on the cheek and he starts bleeding. And what do gods not do? They don't bleed.
Yeah, that sounds a lot like Star Wars.
Yeah. Yeah, well, it is. It's similar, right? It's not at all, but just let him have that one. It's The Last Stand. Yeah, he's got it right, because if you base it on the original Star Wars, right, it's a lot like Star Wars. There's a lot of sand in the original Star Wars. And the original Star Wars, it was actually filmed in Morocco. So there you go. But Morocco's so far away from Afghanistan, it's unbelievable. But there's no sand, but I see the point. But the point is, right, there's The Man Who Would Be King is a book actually written by the very, 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 very great Rudyard Kipling, right? Mark my words, Rudyard Kipling wrote many wonderful books, right? Well over 100 years ago, and this film came out called The Man Who Would Be King. Absolutely brilliant. And the point is, it raised the issue of Afghanistan, how wonderful Afghanistan was with all the gold. Yeah, because Alexander the Great left loads of gold behind in Afghanistan. Well, he was like a bit careless, you know, as you do, Stav. You go and conquer a country and you leave loads of gold behind, but that's the way you do it.
Yeah.
Got it? Good. I'm glad. We're still on the first slide. Anyway, the first slide itself is showing an archaeological site known as Al-Qayyum. And the Al-Qayyum site is a site that's been extensively looted. And what we've got to do, we've got to say no. Don't loot the archaeological site. Don't be that person on the left-hand side of the screen with like a weird sort of mouth and stuff, right? Don't be like it, right? Don't go out looting archaeology. And what you've got to do, you've got to see archaeology as being relevant. It's your identity. It's who you are. Because after Stav, right? It's obvious, isn't it? If Evan wasn't in Cardigan Castle, right? He would be nobody.
That's true.
That is very, very true. So in other words, Evan looks around at Cardigan Castle and he sees this wonderful Norman remains, right? And he sees these really thick walls, right? And he's looking through a narrow window and he hasn't got a proper running toilet, but you know, you can't have it all. Why did he have to spoil it by talking about toilets for? Do you know what I mean? Totally reckless.
No,
the thing is with Evan, right? Evan go to the toilet, so it's not even relevant. Anyway, this is itself, right? They are still excavating in Afghanistan, right? Do you know what? That guy on the left is an absolute poser with a bit of wood.
He looks like someone from the Taliban.
That's me.
Oh my God! Are you saying you're a member? Oh, you're a Taliban? Oh my God!
No! I thought that was an Afghanistan person.
That's an Afghan.
My name is the Jaw Spinner.
Your name is what?
The Jaw Spinner.
What? That's what that is there?
Yeah.
Well, I just make an observation, Stav. Right, last week you couldn't draw anything. Right, this week you're almost as if you're a master drawer.
I thought this is me.
Hold on, eh, bro?
Hang on a minute. This isn't you drawing. Right. Anyway.
I'm in black.
Hang on, right, that's racist, right? You're the one in black.
Oh, no.
Black Lincoln.
Oh, my God. I got to be honest with you, right? The whole point of this, right, is you've written Taliban, and that's really important. So what this is, right, is making the history and archaeology of Afghanistan relevant, not only to the Taliban, to the Mujahideen, to absolutely everybody. Guys, you must have seen the film Rambo.
Oh, yeah.
Rambo 1, 2, and 3. Did you see the second one where Rambo went to Afghanistan? No, it was the third one. Yeah, it was the third one. Rambo went to Afghanistan to... save Colonel Troutman, yeah?
Yeah, I watched all of them. Did you watch the one that came up recently?
Yeah, I really struggled with that. And do you know why I struggled with that? It was just like, I don't know.
He was all old and retired.
Yeah, but it was just like, who actually builds a complete bunker complex under their house with so many arms and ammunition, right, that they could take on a whole army, right? Can I just ask you a question? Have they actually made four films or five?
Five, I think, isn't it?
Five? Have they? No, it's got to be four.
Google it now.
Yeah, Google it now. Right, we know what happened in the first one, right? It was like Rambo going to save some... Rambo trying to take on a town in North America, and he said, don't push me in it, and he's like a vagrant, and somebody gets killed, right? And then you've got the other film where Rambo goes to Vietnam to save some prisoners of war. I think that's the second one. And then the third one, you've got Rambo going into Afghanistan, and that's why we've mentioned it.
Yeah, there's five films.
Yeah, what's the fourth one about then? Because me and Stav want to know.
It's called Rambo.
Well, but what's it about?
It says, Rambo helps a team of Christian missionaries enter Burma to help suffering villagers. However, when the missionaries get captured by Burmese soldiers, Rambo sets out to rescue them.
Oh, wait, I haven't even seen that. Have you seen that, Stav?
No.
Right, we got to see it. Right. And then we know what the fifth one happens. Well done. You know, that's a good bit of research. Anyway, the point is the third film, right? And am I right that the third film, right, your jaw has been spun. Oh, no. Stav, Evan, you can confirm what the fourth film was about. Tell me now again.
So Christian Burma missionaries, yeah.
Yeah, and the third one. No, we told us about the Christian missionaries. Stav could have.
He goes to rescue someone in Afghanistan.
Yeah, we got that right.
When they could have just nuked Afghanistan, please.
Yeah, but the thing is, right, that guy with the shovel there, he don't want to be nuked.
Well, he put his shield around him.
So basically, it's like tactical nuking, and you don't kill him. And you're going to kill the archaeologist as well, who's standing there in a white coat.
Ah, he's fine.
How is he fine?
Well, he's an archaeologist. Like, his white coat is, like, it can't be broken.
Oh, right, yeah, fair enough. Stav? Do you sometimes wonder that Evan likes drinks, a weird type of drink that makes him a bit strange?
I just teleported to the Nether and now I'm back.
Oh my God, you're even worse. Right, okay. So in other words, they've been archaeologically excavating quite a lot over the past 20 years. Now, this in there was once a statue. It was called the Bamiyan statue, right? And a terrible thing, right? Was that the Taliban government, right? The Taliban government in March 2001 blew up the statue, right?
Why?
Oh, it's wonderful.
What was the point in that, though?
But I'll show you what the statue once looked like, right? So I'll actually show you where this place Bamiyan is, right? Who's that stupid drawing? Bamiyan there, right? I shouldn't call him stupid drawings. It's just him. There is Bamiyan. And there's Kabul.
He hurt his feelings.
Is Kabul the place that got blew up?
No, it's not the place that got blew up.
But all this is irrelevant. It doesn't exist.
No. How can it be irrelevant? It's still history. Oh, right, it's irrelevant. Right, guys, so we'll see you next week. And what an absolute numpty. Where's this? Right, Bamiyan statue.
The government's irrelevant, so it shouldn't be...
That statue once stood in there, right? There it is. That statue once
How could it fit in there?
It has reached peak irrelevance.
It looks like Optimus Prime. Optimus Prime.
Yeah, but hang on a minute. No. You're getting all this wrong, right? Basically, right, it was carved into that rock that's in front of us. Yeah?
Well, maybe here's my theory. So, long back in, like, when that was quote-unquote created, yeah? But, like, there's actually giants, yeah?
Please stop.
What's going on?
I don't know. Do you know what we should do? We should have Evan on a ghost walk. It'd be like, yeah.
Oh my god, that'd be brilliant.
Well, I'd just be thinking, well, what's going on? Yeah, I don't know. I just. Anyway, look, no, shut up. Get up. Go away. Anyway, the whole point is, right? Oh no, please help me.
No.
The whole point is, in Afghanistan, right, this statue was blown up by the Taliban, right? And now the Taliban are back in charge, right? Do we trust the Taliban with the history and archaeology of the country, right?
No.
Ah, but you're saying no, right? Because back in 2001, right, they believed that these great Buddhist statues, the one that we've just seen, obviously part of another religion, they don't agree with Islam, and they needed to be removed, so they blew them up, right? And also the Kabul Museum, which once contained 200,000 artifacts on display and in its store thingamajig, right? At least 90% of all the artifacts were sold, destroyed, or whatever, by people looting the museum. Yep. Now, That was all from 1996 to 2001, and the Taliban were removed from power, right? So lots of goods that were actually traded to people in America and Italy and Britain and all the rest of it, all the archaeology itself, some of it has actually been recovered. And unfortunately, that's been sent back to Afghanistan, where it was stolen from in the first place. Now, I'm saying, right, that the history and archaeology of Afghanistan is not just about the people of Afghanistan, but it's about the Taliban as well. And interesting enough, this hole itself, there's nothing in the rock, is actually part of the history of Afghanistan. I know it sounds strange, but every single thing that's happened in history is actually part of history. Stav, you know, you just scratched your nose. That's part of history.
Yeah, that's a historical moment.
It is. It was quite amazing because I knew you scratched your nose, but we didn't even see it.
Yeah.
Whoa. That's a Doctor Strange thing.
Their jaws were spun.
Okay. Back with it, guys. I'm completely in control. But so anyway, the point is, if we sort of move on a little bit, because I'm actually losing the will to live. Hang on, what's happened now? What the hell? Oh my god, this is too much. It's just like really. I don't know what to do. Oh my god, there's a bear. Why the hell is a bear on the screen? Right.
His name is Joe Spinner 2.0.
Is it? Right. Okay. Yeah. Now, guys, in the past 20 years, thanks to American satellites, right, and aerial photography, there was about 1,500 sites known in Afghanistan, you know, all the way going back to the Bronze Age, thousands and thousands of years ago, and all the way back to the period of Alexander the Great, just beyond 300 years BC. All the way into the Bactrian kingdom, which was like a kingdom a bit like ancient Greece, but a bit weird. And then what we had, then we have something known as the Silk Route. Now, we've all heard about the Silk Route, surely, guys. You heard about the Silk Route? I don't believe it. Nobody said anything. You haven't heard about the Silk Route. Well, the Silk Route itself came all the way from
Afghanistan.
Pakistan. Yeah, it came all the way from India, down here. Down to Kabul, down to you, all the way along here, down all the way across, and then into Iran. And that was known as the Silk Route. And why was it called the Silk Route? Because
it passes through a place called Jam.
A lot of soup.
What's that? Look, it's got nothing to do with soup, and it's got nothing to do with octopuses, okay? Don't even mention octopuses, right? The point is, right, the Silk Route itself brought silk all the way from the other side of China, right? All the way through China, which is a big country, right? Maybe it got up into Mongolia as well. That's the way it happens, you know. Let's just go into Mongolia for a couple of weeks. And then all the way across where, which is modern-day Pakistan, right? What and then through that? Pakistan, all the way through Afghanistan, right? All the way from Afghanistan, all the way in... What the hell? What's going on now? Oh, you just put the spider's web over the screen.
No.
You did. You did, because that's what that bloke does. And then, right, all the goods are then traded with... Oh, God, please help me. I don't want to suffer in this way. Anyway, see, I just prayed then and all the stuff went off the screen. I thought that was really effective. Anyway, the Silk Route itself we know existed from at least 200 years before the birth of Christ. Because what they did, they woke up one day and they said, right, Jesus Christ is coming. There's 200 years before him. Job done. So that's how we know it was 200 years before the birth of Christ. Anyway, the point, and actually, Stav, can you get coins which say 20 BC on them?
Yeah.
Yeah, but then... Yeah, but really?
Yeah,
and you just make it. Yeah, you just
make it. So, let me prove you guys your theory is wrong, okay?
What theory? Which one?
Them to Kabul, then to Jam, yeah, and to Herat. But you said it goes to Iran, and Iran, yeah, is down here.
Actually,
it went into a giant's mouth, because remember, a giant statue, that's where giants existed. So it's just a massive fruit to get water to the giant.
Oh, for God's sake. Okay, what is this? Something.
I wish he'd get alive. But the big question is, right? So what you're saying on the return visit, right? What you're saying, right? The whole point of the Silk Route, right, is to trade goods from China, right, and Japan, and Mongolia, all the way through Afghanistan, collect spices and collect lapis lazuli. And lapis lazuli is a beautiful blue stone, right? It's a
beautiful. That's in Minecraft. That was stolen from
there. No, he's got the route wrong. No, you've got the route wrong because. The route, this is actually, that right, that's the border with Iran, right? Just because Iran's down there, this is all Iran, you numpty. So it just went over the border. Do you know what I mean?
Wrong, really? Actually, yeah, it actually started in Tajikistan. Then it went through Afghanistan to Turkmenistan. Then went down to Herat, then down to Lahiri and Bazaar. And then down here, and over here, and then up here to Kandahar, then to Ghazni, and then Kabul, then to Jalalabad, Hamdang, then to South Carolina,
then to, that's in America.
To Jam, and back to Hermit, and then back to Iran.
Oh no, that's really good. At least we eventually got there, didn't we, Stav?
It's one way, yeah.
That's right, yeah. And like, it didn't go. And then before the driving north, is that like before they went to Iran, the driving north, is that like Mr. Pakistan said, go back over here to Pakistan.
Stav, do you know what's going on?
Over you.
I don't know.
I don't even think he knows what's going on.
Evan, right? God. We go all the way over to all the way into Iraq, right, and then we go over to Lebanon, and we go all the way over to the coast, right, and then objects are traded all the way then back to China, and that's how, right, that's how we found on some archaeological sites in China, material from the Roman Empire because of the Silk Route, because goods were coming from China all the way into Europe and the Lebanon and Syria and all the rest of it. And then goods went from Syria, right, all the way then back to China, like copper objects, you know, precious stones, even pottery. It was all even coins went all the way back to China. And this is how we know what's going on. And in fact, Afghanistan is a very, very important country because it's at the interchange, right? Really good word there. It's at the interchange between culture. Because you think, right, in Afghanistan, right, over many thousands of years, people have traded into Afghanistan and they've traded it out of Afghanistan into places like modern day Turkey, modern day Turkey, modern day Russia, Turkmenistan, modern day Russia. And then they've traded from the likes of in from China, and they've actually traded back into China. And then they've traded from the south in India, all the way back into India, right? And then they've traded all the way from Iran and back out of Iran. So basically, this is the center of all this trade.
What about the British Empire?
It's 10:15, Carl. We've got like 20 minutes left.
Really? No, we can't. I haven't told you. You know, Evan asked something sensible, Stav, and what we've got to do, we've got to answer it. Right? Now, did you know the British invaded Afghanistan in the first Afghan war?
Oh, yeah.
In the late 1830s. And guess what? The Afghan people defeated the British Empire. So the British actually lost.
They also defeated USA.
No, we didn't defeat the USA.
No, Taliban did.
Oh, well, you know, that goes without saying. You know, even...
They left like 10 billion in equipment.
Even Stav knows that. Even Stav knows that.
Yeah, even I know that.
Even you know that.
Just Ted, you know that.
No, the question probably. Is... Well, hang on a minute, hang on. No, not probably. Ask him. Ask him, Evan. Don't just presume. Hang on. Do you know what? I've lost where I am now. I've completely lost. What was I talking about? Oh, right, yeah, the British Empire. And in fact, so many countries have actually invaded or tried to invade Afghanistan, right? The Persians have tried to invade Afghanistan. Even the Mongols tried to invade Afghanistan in the 1300s, but they failed. Anyone who's tried to invade Afghanistan has actually failed, right? Alexander the Great actually invaded Afghanistan, left some cities behind, but, you know, he wasn't there long enough to actually fail because he died, right? Because as Stav knows, because he met him. But anyway, the point is then the British actually invaded Afghanistan and he tried to defeat Afghanistan and they couldn't, right? And then the French go into Afghanistan, they go in as archaeologists, you know. You know, some of the later invasions in 1979, the Russians invade Afghanistan. That's why we mentioned the third Rambo film, because that's what that's about. And then what happens? The Taliban invade Afghanistan, right? So they're kicked out they're there from 1996 to 2001. And then the Americans invade Afghanistan and they're kicked out. And guess who's back? The Taliban.
Isn't Taliban, like a rebellion.
No, the weird thing is, do you really want the answer? Because I've actually done a video and I've done some research into this. The Taliban actually started off as educated students. It was a group of educated students who didn't like what was going on, but it basically got taken over by extreme Muslims, Islamists. Who most Islamists don't like because they're just really, really extreme. And they follow something called Sharia law. And in Sharia law, you can be stoned to death or you can be forcibly made to stand under a wall and the wall toppled on top of you.
That's a bit extreme.
Yeah, I think it's a bit extreme, yeah. But in other words, the strange thing is, like most movements in history, it's like Les Miserables, you know, all that type of stuff with you're talking about. That's based in 1871, isn't it? But if you look at the French Revolution, nobody actually set out to guillotine the king. It was actually people were saying, look, we need food, you know, you're not feeding us. Nobody actually set out to kill anybody like that, but that's exactly what happened, right? And it was the same. The Taliban didn't start off the way they started off. They didn't start beheading people. It was not what they believed in. But they eventually started to do that. And also the other thing as well is this will really interest Evan. Hey, Stav, this will really get Evan interested. The monarchy, the Romanov monarchy in Russia, right? that was captured in 1917 and then executed at Katynberg in 1918, right? So they executed all the Russian royal family, right?
And the kids.
And the children, yeah. Anastasia was one of the most famous one. And actually, they say that Anastasia may have survived, but nobody actually thinks that. But, you know, there was talk years after that Anastasia did actually survive. Anyway, the point is that nobody set out to actually do all this. But unfortunately, warfare breeds warfare and death, and people get worse and worse and worse and worse and worse. And this is the problem throughout history. Okay, the other thing as well is you know, such as Adolf Hitler in the Second World War and the Nazis. Did the Nazis actually originally set out to do what they did to the Jews, the Jehovah's Witnesses, the Gypsies and all the rest of it? I don't think they actually set out to do that. In fact, the final solution was put together by Reinhard Heydrich at the conference in 1941 to the final solution with the Jews. So the Nazis never actually set out to do that. It was actually what happened years later. Right. And the problem is, this is what happens with warfare and rebellions. You've either got to stop them or it gets worse and worse and worse and worse. And this is what we see in history.
Yeah, I reckon they wanted to send them to Madagascar.
What? Send all the people from Afghanistan to Madagascar?
Yeah, I reckon the Nazis wanted to send all the Jews to Madagascar.
How do you know about that? Not many people know that. Oh my God, Stav, he's really been doing his research. Do you know what, right? That is very, very true. The original plan, right, was instead of gassing, it wasn't just the Jews. It was, there was 6 million Jews went to the camps, and it was also 6 million Jehovah's Witnesses, disabled, gay, gypsies, and all these other people went, right? But the Jews, they said, would have gone to Madagascar. That's not many people know that. You've really been looking into this one. I am actually quite surprised. Actually, Stav, you are a bit behind today because you've got to come up with a fact that nobody knows. So, Stav, you've got to do it. Otherwise, it would be a complete fail. I'll have failed in life.
Okay.
Go on, Stav. You've got to give it to us now, just like that. Go on. Make it up.
Hitler died.
Ah, no, me and Evan think he didn't. He went to
Argentina.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, no, well, yeah.
Argentina.
Died.
Yeah. What? Where did he die? What's the point?
Argentina.
He died in a basement of his house.
Well, like, the other day the other month, actually, on the TV, I saw a thing that said, like, they were, like, searching Argentina for, like, bunkers. And they found, like, a Nazi arm factory or something, with Nazi flags and stuff.
Did they?
Yeah.
Oh, in Argentina?
Yeah.
Right, they were searching the forest and stuff, and they found all this.
And they found, like, a building, like a Nazi building.
Oh, right, with all the, with, like, all the stuff in it.
Yeah, they found guns and stuff, too.
And flags?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, that's wicked! Oh, we'll have to do that next week. Right. Anyway, we haven't got past this image, man, because somebody started talking about something
on YouTube.
Completely random. But the one thing is that all these artifacts have been leaving Afghanistan, and the big question is, do we allow the Taliban to have this stuff back to put in their museums? Are they going to use them to encourage tourists to go to the country? The big question, Stav, would you go to Afghanistan on a holiday if there was a brilliant museum to look at artifacts in?
No.
Why not?
It's a bit dangerous.
Well, you know what? Okay, what if you had a personal letter from the Afghan government to say, come on over, Stav, right? Come and have a look at the artifacts in the museum. Your mum's got to come over, right?
It could be a complete trick.
So what they've done, they sat down, right, and they built this museum for you, sent you images, right, with all these artifacts in, right, and you think it's a trick?
I'd have to go in with 3 FBI teams, a SWAT van with a couple more SWAT guys, and the entire police force.
What, of Barry?
Of all of Wales.
Well, there's only 5 people, so that's not going to make much difference, really, is it? You know. Anyway, The point is, right, that one on the right there is ivory, and the one on the bottom is a Bactrian coin, which looks very Greek and Hellenistic. So what we're trying to say...
Oh, it looks like Spanish.
Yeah, all right, then. He might look a bit Spanish. He's got a big nose. Look at the size of my nose. It's huge, but I'm not Spanish.
I'm not talking about the armor.
What?
The armor.
What, he looks Spanish?
Yeah, the armor.
Well, you never know. There could be Spanish influences. But anyway, these look very, very Western. And what we're doing is losing lots of artifacts. And this itself is one of a Buddhist painting. And what's happened, what they've been doing over the past many years.
Is it the oldest oil painting in the world?
Oh, my God. That's absolutely amazing. How the hell did you know that?
How? Is that Bamiyan?
That's amazing. Do you know what, right? Evan is so well educated, you know. I don't even know why he's bothered doing this, right?
How did he know that, though?
Yeah, it's just amazing. It's amazing. It's amazing.
How?
Yeah, because he's so, you know, ask. I tell you what, ask Evan, right, where this painting was done, and he will tell you. Without.
No, is it done?
Evan, he was Afghanistan.
Yeah, but where?
I'm going to say Bamiyan.
Yeah, exactly. That's amazing. You two guys just know so much about this. It's amazing. It's just like, I don't even know why I'm bothering teaching you this.
It says in the top left.
Oh, like now you've actually totally spoiled it now because Stan thought you were really intelligent.
I genuinely did.
Yeah. Evan, right? Do you know what? Right? 1 minute, right? You made Stav idolise you. He just thought, right, Evan's the most amazing person on the planet. He knows absolutely everything. And you just spoiled it, Evan. What'd you do that for?
Yeah, Evan. God.
Evan, you've ruined it now. Stav could have followed you forever. And when you're older and you've got no money, he could have given you loads of money because he thought you were so amazing.
Well, you give me money anyway.
Yeah, well, you know, that's true. That goes without saying, you know. Anyway, what they did when the statues were blown up in 2001, what they did, they looked at all the caves because Buddhists live in caves. They live in these little caves, probably with a bucket to, and a bowl for food and some water and stuff. And what happened, right, is that these absolutely beautiful oil paintings. Right, these absolutely beautiful oil paintings. They've actually started finding loads of these beautiful oil paintings in these caves that they didn't know existed. And as you're so rightly saying, at Bamiyan, these are the oldest known oil paintings in the world ever. Actually, they date back to about 500-600. And they're out.
It's Bamiyan.
From Bamiyan, yeah. They don't overdo it, you know.
No, what is it like?
Oh. Well, hang on a minute. I'll give you a clue, right? Bamiyan is in which country?
Russia.
Oh, for God's sake.
No, Afghanistan.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. It was a bit of a clue. You know, that's what we're doing, right? So I do believe that there may have actually, oil paintings may have existed all the way back to sort of the later Roman period, but... These are some very incredibly old examples of oil paintings to actually be found at Bamiyan in Afghanistan, as we're well aware. And look at that there. Doesn't that look lush?
Looks a red leg.
You know, it's like Bagram glass. Bagram. And actually, there was an air base at Bagram as well, because if you can remember, it was the Americans at the Bagram air base. Yes. So the American air base at Bagram is obviously no longer an American air base at Bagram, but this itself is glass from Bagram in Afghanistan and the north eastern part of the country, and this itself gives you an idea of the wonderful glass that has been traded with the people of Afghanistan. So this is one of those trade objects that has made it into Afghanistan. And obviously, in the excavations, this was taken out and taken over to Paris, right? So this, and it gives you an idea of the beautiful wealth that's available in the likes of Afghanistan. And again, guys, I know that this is absolutely terrible, that this statue was blown up. And what they did for a few years after, they broke all the bits of the statue up and used it for building in a nearby town. So now today, what they've done an avatar right, of this, and they project it on the wall. So you can go there and still see the statue, but it's not there. You know, it's the same thing. It's the same thing I feel like today. I don't even know if I'm talking to anyone.
How can you see it if, like, it's not there?
It's an avatar. Oh my God, you don't know what an avatar is.
Oh, God.
An avatar is a representation of something. It's like, do you know the band ABBA?
ABBA.
Waterloo. La 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 la. Waterloo.
Aren't they Swedish?
Yeah. Top marks. And they had a number of number ones. They've actually come back together, right? After 39 years, right? And they're so old. I think the lead singer, Bjorn, in ABBA is like 106 years old, right? No, he's actually 76, right? But it's so great. They've actually come back together again to actually perform on the stage and actually make videos. And what they've done, they've signed up with Steven Spielberg, right, to actually make them look young again as avatars, right? And there's going to be performances with them on stage, but played by avatars. Right, get it?
Yeah, but didn't they make a film?
They make what?
They made a film, didn't they? About these songs.
Yeah, they did. They made loads of films. Yeah.
Mamma Mia or something, isn't it?
Mamma Mia. No, yeah, a theatre production. Mamma Mia. La 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 da 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 na 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 na. Mamma Mia. That one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you know my favourite one is Fernando? That's brilliant. I love that one by ABBA. It's good.
I don't know that one.
Chicken Tikka, that's good as well. No, it's called Chicka Tikka, but I call it Chicken Tikka because you can remember it that way. Right, okay, guys. Oh, there it is. There you go. But you can get an idea how rich this landscape is. So now...
That's tall.
What's that?
That's tall.
Yeah, I know what it is.
I'm probably taller.
Are you? Well, how tall are you? 3'2"?
I'm like, let's say 20'5", something like that.
Oh, 20'5". So you think you're taller than this then, right?
Yeah.
No, I'm like 30'5".
No, I mean, I was actually joking. I'm like 12,000'5".
Yeah. I'm 12,001 foot high.
I'm 12,002 foot high.
I'm 13,000 foot high.
I'm 14,000 foot high.
I'm 14,001 foot high.
Guys,
I'm 100,000 foot high.
Guys, can somebody tell me what's going on? Because I don't know what's going on anymore, right?
These
statues were probably built around 1,500 years ago, and the tall one was 55 meters tall, which is actually smaller than Stan, but that's life.
I'm taller than it, you know.
What? So guys, I've got to show you both the statues, right? The one that's 38 meters tall and the one that's 55 meters tall. So I've got to show you this on the screen. Now, where is it? New share. There it is. Now, that one's the 55 meter tall one, which was blown up. And just look at that. Look how small that person is there.
Why do they have to blow it up?
What?
Why do they have to blow it up?
Because it didn't agree with their religion. It didn't agree with Islam, and they didn't want it anymore. So they just decided to get rid of it. So they blew it up. And then you've got the other one, which is over here.
Why didn't they blow themselves up?
I made that statue.
What, you made that one?
No, I made the one before it.
Yeah, well, if you made that one, who made that one then?
My brother.
Your brother?
Yeah.
Can I just ask you a question? But you didn't even know you had a brother.
Yeah, that's the thing. I've only just met him like a couple of days ago.
How is one 38 meters, yeah, and one's 52, And like they're in the same spot.
What?
They're like they're in the same spot, and how is one smaller than the other?
No, they're not on the same spot. No, they're not on the same spot. They're in two different locations, but in the same area. So did you actually get it now? So what you thought, what that statue was in the same place as this statue?
Yeah.
Yeah, but how? Do you know what I mean? It's just like...
It looks kind of similar. I thought they were back on the other side, on like opposite side of the mountain.
Well, no.
No, I actually thought you meant that one was in front of this one, but you could see behind this one and then see this, because that one was hiding, but in front of this one, therefore they were in the same place.
Yeah.
Does that make any sense?
Yeah, loads.
All right, good. I'm glad because I've actually lost the will to live at this stage. But anyway, like moving on. Oh, look at that. There he is. There he is. Yeah, it didn't agree with their, it didn't agree. They blew him up because it just didn't agree with their teachings, right? And look at that there. That is actually key.
He looks like 60, 80.
This is actually key. A nation stays alive when its culture stays alive. So in other words, right, a nation exists, right? A nation actually is, and a nation is actually based on its culture, because without any identity, for example, right, in Britain, we have all the really old prehistoric stuff before the Romans. Then we have like the Roman influence, and then we have like in Wales in particular, we have the Viking influence. And then we've got all the native princes of Cymru, which is great. And then we have the Norman influence, which is not so great. And then we've got everything about the Tudors. So and everything else, and everything else comes, the Stuarts and the Victorians and everything, right? And all these other people coming over as well. So all that's actually part of our culture. But what we got to do is to put it all together and actually say, that's our identity. But unfortunately, many countries like to, for example, in Cymru, Wales, lots of times the real history of Wales is actually forgotten about and dismissed. Evan's dad knows that one. And Stav, did you actually come to Dinas Powys Castle with me?
No, I went with my nan though.
Yeah, your nan did. She did. And one thing I was saying about Dinas Powys Castle, it's such a great castle, but unfortunately, Dinas Powys Castle was more than anything built by a native lord, by a native prince before the Normans. And it's a really well intact castle, but unfortunately today, it has been allowed to erode and fall apart. So in other words, this is a good statement, even though it's about Afghanistan, this is about Wales as well, and Scotland and every other country. A nation stays alive when its culture stays alive and has a sense of belief. Right. So the point, you know what we've got to do, Stav, right? We've got to show you guys a photograph of Dinas Powys Castle to show you what I mean. Dinas Powys Castle. And actually, we could do a little bit of Dinas Powys Castle next week. Dinas Powys Castle, Right, okay. This itself, I'm going to show you an image of, this is what a Dinas Powys Castle looked like about 50 years ago. There it is. Look at those impressive walls. That's so amazing. And that is actually down the road from where Stav lives. No, it isn't. Hang on. Show, right, there's only one gateway at Dinas Powys Castle, and Dinas Powys Castle is basically where that is there today. So we might have a little bit of a look at Dinas. I'm sure we've done Dinas Powys Castle before. What's that?
Castell Coch.
Yeah, but Castell Coch was built, rebuilt by William Burgess in 1877. But it's based on the foundations of the original native Welsh-built castle. So this is what Dinas Powys Castle looks like. Anyway, we could possibly do a little bit about Dinas Powys. Guys, we're gonna have to go in about 6 minutes. But are you guys wanting to do this next week?
Let's do music time.
All right. Okay. Okay. I tell you what. We'll end the Afghanistan thing in a few moments. Right. We'll have a bit of music, Tom, and then we'll call it a day. Are you guys wanted to do this next week or the following week?
Next week.
What about you, Steve?
Yeah, I'll do it next week.
What about you, Dave? Yeah, that's a yes from four people.
Yeah.
So in other words, we'll just finish the Afghanistan.
Adolf Hitler.
What?
Adolf Hitler, you've got to ask.
The Anna Nürbe next week as well.
Nine.
Ich stecke die Deutschwagen, Deutsch, Nage, not in Deutschland. But anyway, so we're back to the image that we were on, right? Back to the original image. I'm just going to quickly show you now. And obviously what they are now doing in Afghanistan, they're making Afghan people look at their own history and archaeology in Afghanistan. And history and archaeology of Afghanistan is being very important to the Afghan people and hopefully to the new rulers of Afghanistan. And quickly, we're just showing a little bit of a map about... And
I all the good found
out of Afghanistan. Shut up. And this is actually found in a city known as Persepolis. And Persepolis existed at the time of Alexander the Great. And those guys, what's happening is that people are actually trading goods like lapis lazuli, which is that wonderful blue stone, from Afghanistan all the way to the likes of Persepolis and Iraq. And so there's this great trade link. We've known about it for years. Just quick image of goods, artifacts actually seized at Heathrow Airport that have actually come from Afghanistan, have been stolen from Afghanistan. Again, we know this. And unfortunately, lots of statues and so on have been destroyed by the Taliban in 2001. But hopefully it's not going to happen now. Lots of the records in the museum in Kabul were destroyed, but we're able to work out some of the artifacts that used to exist in the museum at Kabul. And lots of artifacts actually, if anyone ever sees any of these artifacts, it's come from Afghanistan and they've got a watch list to actually see if there's any goods that have been traded out of the country. And a little bit of a map here, just sort of showing sites that have been looted, because there's a lot of looting going on. But what we can do is keep an eye on Afghanistan and see if there's any damage being caused to these archaeological sites from above, because we now know there are thousands of more archaeological sites through all the aerial photography that we've been doing than we knew before. And this is actually tablets showing the original Afghan writing back about 2,200 years ago, called Bactrian, and it's based on ancient Greek writing. And the ones here are missing, but we managed to put loads of these together. And then that's that. So what we'll do now, any questions on that you two guys, and then we'll do a bit of the old Tunu-Tunu-Nuka.
Are we going to do the Mexican one?
Well, we can only do one, and we've only got about two or 3 minutes.
Mexican.
All right, then, do Mexican. Go on, go for it. But me and Steph, you know, I got to be dancing by myself here on the screen all by myself, but don't worry about it, it's fine.
So, yeah.
Well, come on, hurry up. Come on, chop, chop. God, he's a bit slow today. He should have already had it ready.
Yeah, Evan.
It's better. Oh, no, it's not better than two. Oh, the Mexican bloke.
Because students have a lack.
He's not Mexican.
Hang on.
What I gotta do is if I gotta share. You gotta share sound. Go on.
Sound.
I've just done it. Am I?
Hear that, then.
Go on, then.
Can you hear that?
No.
I'll just hear it.
I can't hear anything.
Help.
Are you sharing sound? No, you've paused it, you numpty.
Okay, I'm sharing sound.
Not a great move, right? I love the green. What language is this?
Ida pam para ki tuve de ram be de ram faster than my run.
What? I'm getting into it. Oh god. Anyway, guys, that was cool.
That was cool, bruh.
That was good. Cool, bruh. So guys, bruv, right? We gotta have the tuna two Mac back to guy, and then we'll do this guy next week, and we gotta find someone else.
Tuna man.
That's next week. So guys, any questions to ask before we go? Well done on that. The dancing there was great. Joy, yeah, I particularly like the hand movements. Like,
yeah. Who licks Spider-Man?
Stav.
Me, bro.
Yeah, like, bro.
Who thinks Spider-Man is better than this?
Yeah, definitely.
Ultimately.
Yeah, and we also think Spider-Man's better than this piece of paper.
Yeah.
And a pen.
But do you think Spider-Man's better than this PC?
No, definitely not, because we wouldn't be able to listen to the music. And the other thing as well is Spider-Man is not as good as this tomato sauce when you're eating French fries from McDonald's.
Oh, is Spider-Man better than Xbox?
Well, actually, Spider-Man's a complete fail, but other than that, it's good.
Xbox better than Spider-Man.
Yeah, exactly. Right, guys, on that note, right, hopefully you two have a good time. If there's no other questions, right, We will see you brothers and your sisters next week, right? We are going to get straight into the Tunak next week. We'll have a bit of the old Dennis Pass Castle. We'll have a bit of the Anna Nurby and the German archaeologists excavating in the wall, because you're obsessed with it, Evan, and we have to do it sometime. Stav, anything you want to say quickly before we go?
Nah.
That was really good. That was a really good contribution, Stav. I really appreciated that.
World map.
And then finally... Is that your contribution now, Evan?
Yeah, you have a map.
Yeah, looking at the map, yeah. We got it. We love it. Yeah. We'll have that next week. Cool. Anyway, guys, we're going to call it a day. So, Evan and Stav, I'll see you next week.
Good evening and goodbye.
Watch and enjoy. Don't do anything I wouldn't do, but do what I would do and not. And that's everything fine. And thank you very much for joining me. We'll have a great time next week as well. Take care.
Okay, yes. Bye. Take care, bro.
Take care, bro, and Evan and Stav. Cheers, bruv.
Yeah.
Cheers. Awesome. Excellent. Cool. That's good. Anyway, thank you on this recording. That's the Young Explorers, and members of my channel will be able to watch this, and then hopefully you've enjoyed. Take care.